हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द प्रताप लर्निंग। लेट्स स्टार्ट विद फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन। हाउ मेनी वेज टू क्रिएट ऑब्जेक्ट इन जावा? इट्स अ वेरी कॉमन क्वेश्चन इन इंटरव्यू रूम फॉर फ्रेशर एंड एक्सपीरियंस। फर्स्ट वे टू क्रिएट ऑब्जेक्ट इज न्यू कीवर्ड, एंड इन दिस केस कंस्ट्रक्टर गेट कॉल्ड, एंड इट इज द मोस्ट कॉमन वे टू क्रिएट एन ऑब्जेक्ट इन जावा। Almost 99% of objects are created in this way. Second way to create object is class.forName, or you can say reflection, and in this case constructor get called. When we need to use this way? If we know the name of class and if it has a public or default constructor. Third way to create object is clone method, and in this case constructor not called, and the clone method can be used to create a copy of an existing object. So now fourth way to create object is deserialization, and in this case constructor not called, and we will discuss about deserialization in details after some time in separate question. Second question is, what is a constructor, and is It is also important question for freshers. So constructor is just like a method that it used to initialize the state of an object, and it is invoked at the time of object creation. Normally constructors are for initializing non-static member of particular class with respect to the object. And here one more thing, return type of constructor. And its simplicity returns the current instance of the class, and you can't use an explicit return type with the constructor, means you cannot customize return type of constructor. Third question, what is a static method? You can say a static method belongs to the class rather than an object of class, or you can say it can be invoked without the need for creating an instance of a class. And static method can access static data member and can change the value of it. So first line is important for fresher, you need to read this in details. Fourth question, can we execute a Java program without main method? Answer is yes, because static block execute first and it executed before main method at the time of class loading. Next question, what is the concept of string constant pool and string literals? So when we create a string object with a new keyword, then in that case every time one new object will be created in heap memory. So now what is a string constant pool? If we use string literal concept, then the object is stored in string constant pool area. It is present inside heap memory. And when we create string object with string literal concept, then in that case it will check if object is already present in string constant pool, then it won't create a new object. It will give the reference of existing object. So you can see the complete example which I mentioned here. In the case of string 1, new object created in heap area. In the case of string 2, new object created in string constant pool. In the case of string 3, new object created in heap area. In the case of string 4, new object won't create because Java 5 string object is already present in constant pool. So total 3 objects present here, 2 in heap area and 1 in constant pool. Now sixth question, where is constant pool memory allocated or heap memory concept? All kind of object will be created in heap only. And heap memory is again divided into three portions. First one is young generation, And it is store objects which have a short life, and young generation itself can be divided into two categories, eater space and survivor space. So now second one is the old generation. It is store objects which have survived many garbage collection cycles and is still being referenced. So now third one is permanent generation. It stores metadata about the program like runtime constant pool. So string constant pool memories also belong to the permanent generation. Next question, what is a covariant return type? If we change the return type of override method and returns on class reference, that is called covariant return type. And you can understand covariant return type with this example. Next question. What is blank final variable? A final variable that is not initialized at the time of declaration is known as blank final variable. If you want to create a variable that is not initialized at the time of creating object, and once initialized may not be changed, and it can be initialized only in constructor. You can see related example here. Next question. What is static blank final variable and when is initialized? A static final variable that is not initialized at the time of declaration is known as static blank final variable. It can be initialized only in a static block, and you can find below related example. Next question. What is polymorphism and type of polymorphism in Java? Polymorphism in which we can perform a single action and task by different ways. There are two type of polymorphism in Java. First one is compile time and second one is runtime. If you overload a static method in Java, it is the example of compile time polymorphism. You can see below example. Now, if an override method is called through the reference variable of superclass, it is an example of runtime polymorphism. Next question. What is the difference between static winding and dynamic winding? So, in case of static winding, type of object is determined at compile time, whereas in dynamic winding, type of object is determined at runtime. Next question. What is upcasting? When a reference variable of parent class refers to the object of child class, it is known as upcasting. This is an example of upcasting. Next question. What is abstraction and abstract class? Abstraction is a process of hiding the implementation details and showing only functionality to the user. A class that is declared as abstract is known as abstract class. It cannot be instantiated. Interface is 100% example of abstraction. An abstract class could be 0 to 100%. Now next question. Difference between abstraction and encapsulation. So abstraction hides the implementation details, whereas encapsulation, winding code and data into a single unit. JavaBean is the fully encapsulate class because all the data members are private here. Next question. What is interface and advantage of interface? An interface in Java is a blueprint of a class. It has a static constant and abstract methods, and it is used to achieve abstraction, loose coupling, and multiple inheritance in Java. Next question. Can you declare an interface method static, and can interface be final? Answer is no, because methods of an interface is abstract by default, and static and abstract keyword can't be used together. Or you can say its implementation is provided by another class. Next question. What is marker interface? An interface that have no data member and method is known as marker interface. For example, serializable and clonable. Next question. Difference between abstract class and interface. It is also common question in interview room. So now difference. First one is abstract class can have method body or also can have non-abstract methods. An interface can have only abstract methods. Second difference. Abstract class can have instance variable. An interface can not have instance variables. Third one is abstract class can have constructor and interface cannot have constructor. So now fourth difference, you can extend one abstract class and interface you can implement multiple interface. Next question. What is static import in Java? So why static import? We can access the static member of a class directly. There is no need to call it with the class name. You can see below example to know more about static import. Next question. How to create immutable class in Java? It is most important question for interview room. So we will create immutable class in 5 steps. First one, class must be declared as final so that child class can't be created. Second step, data member in the class must be declared as final so that we can change the value of it after object creation. Third step, create a parameter as constructor. Now fourth step, there should be a getter method for all variable. So now last one, there should be no setter method because so we can't change the value of instance variable. Next question. Why string objects are immutable in Java? Answer is because Java uses the concept of string literal. Suppose there are 5 reference variables that all refers to the one object Sachin. If one reference variable changes the value of the object, it will be affected to all the reference variables. That is why string objects are immutable in Java. It is also very important question for interview. If you don't understand here, then you can also take help to another tutorial to understand this concept in details. Next question. In how many ways we can create the string object? So there are two ways to create the string object. One is string literal and second one is new keyword. And to make Java more memory efficient, we use string literal concept. We have already discussed this concept in details on string constant pool question. Next question. Can a class have an interface? And can an interface have a class? Answer is yes. It is known as nested interface. Or you can say, if we define a class inside the interface, Java compiler creates a static nested class. Next question. What is garbage collection and GC method? Garbage collection is a process of destroy the runtime unused objects. It is performed for memory management. And GC method is a daemon thread, and it is used to send request to JVM to perform garbage collection. You will know about daemon threaded multi-threading concept. Next question. What is singleton class and how can we make a class a singleton? Singleton class means you can create only one object or instance of a class at a time. And if you try to instantiate the singleton class, the new variable also points to the first instance created. To design a singleton class, make constructor as a private. Next question. Difference between final, finally, and finalize. So now final. It is keyword and it is applicable for variable, method, and class. In the case of final variable, you can't change the value. And in the case of final method, you can't override method. In the case of final class, you can't extend the class or inherit the class. So now finally, finally is block and used to handle exception and it is always execute. Now finalize. Finalize is method and used in garbage collection. And second point, it is invoked just before the object is garbage collected and can be used to perform any cleanup or processing. Next question. What is serialization and deserialization? So serialization is a mechanism of converting the state of an object into a byte string. We can send it over the network or save it as a file or store in DB for later uses. And if you define any data member as transient, then it will not be serialized. Now the reverse operation of serialization is called deserialization. Means the process of converting stream data into the object is called deserialization. Next question. What is reflection So reflection is the process of modifying the runtime behavior of class at runtime. You can find reflection example in next question. Next question. Can you access the private method from outside the class? Yes, you can. You can call the private method from outside the class by changing the runtime behavior of the class. You can find below example where private method is calling by reflection. Next question. Difference between final and immutable. Final means you can't change the object reference, but you can still change the value of object using setter methods. Immutable means you can't change object actual value, but you can change the reference. Just taking one example. If array list is final, you can modify the object, like add or remove operation will work. Just think. Now answer is yes. You can modify the data of array list because we can change the value of final object. Next question. What is diamond operator in Java 7? So before diamond operator, we will discuss about generic concept. It is concept which comes in Java 5 due to compile time error in typecasting of collection object. You can see this example. Here we type casting list object in string, then we will get compile time error. So now after Java 5, we can mention type of object in collection. You can find this example. So now comes on diamond operator. In diamond operator, you don't need to mention type parameter during generic class instantiation. See this example. Next question. Java is passed by value? Answer is yes. Java is passed by value. You can prove that by swap example. See this example and run in your local Java environment. Next question. How service string work internally? The string is like a utility class and it store character sequence as an array. If we call service string method, then it will always return new string object. Now we take scenario of service string before Java 7. Now if we call service string method, a new string will be created with same length but with change offset. Due to this, a new V will be created with same length. So if our string is very long, Then in that case, there could be issue of memory leak. So now we will see scenario of string after Java 7. Instead of sharing original character array, substring method creates a copy of it. A new character array is created every time because there is no more offset or count field in the string class. You can see example in both images. One question is asked in interview room, which method used in case of substring in Java 7? Answer is arrays.copy of range. It is used to create a new copy of substring. Next question. Next question is very important for fresher because it will ask why so many interviewers. So question is, what is the meaning of public static void main? So here first one is access modifier, which is public, means we can access from anywhere. Here second one, static keyword, means we don't need to create object to access this method. Here third one is void keyword, means method will return nothing. Here fourth one is main method, it's a entry point for JVM. Here fifth one is string array argument, which can be passed by command line. Next question. What is hash code caching in Haspen? So when string hash code calculate first time, then it has been stored in string object. So next time if string object used, it don't calculate hash code, it's passed case hash code. So you can see below example here. Next question. If constructor is private, then how can we create object of that class? Yes, we can create the object by static factory method. Next question. Difference between super and this keyword. Super keyword used to call parent class variables and method. This keyword is used to call same class variable and method. We can't use them in static area. Next question. Difference between super method and this method and constructor chaining. Super method used to call parent class constructor. This method used to call same class constructor. We can use super and this method only in constructor. You can see below example. Next question. Difference between double equal or dot equals method. So double equal operator for reference comparison and dot equals method for content comparison. Next question. What is association, aggregation and composition in Java? Association refers to the relationship between multiple objects and it's have two type, aggregation and composition. Association can be type of one-to-one, one-to-many, many-to-one, many-to-many relationship. Aggregation represents has a relationship and one-way relationship, or you can say if two objects can exist independently and we can call it a weak association. You can find below example of that. Now composition. Composition represents part of relationship, and both the entities are dependent on each other. Or you can say if two objects can't exist independently, and we can call it a strong type of association. You can see below example to understand more. Next question. Can an interface implement or extend another interface? So, interface does not implement the method of another interface, but we can extend them one interface into the another. An interface means behavior, not the implementation. So, a class or abstract class can implement an interface fully or partially. From Java 8, interface can have default method implementations. Next question. Which class is the superclass for all the classes? So the answer is object class. Next question. What is the purpose of runtime class? Java runtime class provides method to execute a process, invoke GC, get total and free memory. There is only one instance of runtime classes available for JVM. So the get runtime method returns the singleton instance of runtime class. Next question. Difference between serializable and externalizable. So serialization provides default functionality to store and later recreate the object. Suppose you have a linked list object, then the default serialization will discover all the objects which are linked and will serialize with no constructor call. But if you want restricted serialization or don't want some portion of your object to be serialized, then use externalizable. The externalizable interface extends the serializable interface and adds two methods, write external and read external. These methods are automatically called while we do serialization or deserialization. So while working with externalizable, we should remember that the default constructor should be public, and externalizable interface is child interface of serializable, means externalizable extend serializable. So let's see example of externalizable. We can observe that as a password is sensitive information, so I am not serializing it. That the flexibility that is provided by the externalizable. Next question. Why Java doesn't support multiple inheritance? Java doesn't support multiple inheritance directly because it leads to ambiguity. If we override methods when both extended classes have a same method name. This problem can be solved using interface which works similar to the multiple inheritance. Let's see one example. Two class A and B having same method M1, and class C extend both A and B class. Now see second example. It is called diamond problem. So, due to this reason, Java doesn't support multiple inheritance. Next question. can be overload main method? Answer is yes. You can overload the main method, but only main method with string parameter will be used when your class is launched by the JVM. So you can see the below example of overloading of main method. Next question, what is access modifier? So there are four modifiers in Java. First one is public. The classes, methods or variables which are defined as a public can be accessed by any class or method. Second one is protected. Protected can be accessed by the class of the same package or by the subclass of this class or within same class. Third one is default. Default are accessible within the package only. By default, all the classes, methods and variables are the default scope. Fourth one is private. The private class, methods or variable defined as private can be accessed within the class only. Next question, what are the wrapper classes? Wrapper class in Java are the object representation of 8 primitive types. All the wrapper classes in Java are immutable and final. You can see below wrapper classes against primitive types. Next question, can we change the scope of the overridden method in the subclass? Let's see one example of inheritance, where parent class method is public. And assume there is some classes which are using overriding method. Now, if we change the access of overriding method to anything else than public, in that case, some of the classes which were able to use the functionality of method M may not be able to access the function. So hence the rule is overriding method should not decrease the scope of overridden method, but we can increase the scope. Next question. Difference between string, string buffer and string builder in Java programming. So first difference, string is immutable, whereas string buffer and string builder are mutable classes. Second one is, string buffer is thread safe and synchronized, whereas string builder is not. That's why string builder is more faster than string buffer. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe our channel. And if you like this video, then click on like button and leave your comment.